to like make albums and make them better, mm-hmm. And just, you know, explore, be an artist.
Yeah,
it's not a mm-hmm. It's not a like I have to churn out yogurt. This is stuff that lives and reflects life, and mm-hmm. so I need to have that kind of life.
Tell me, Jeff, do you see any like musicians maybe, you know, 10 or 20 years older than you and think of them as like a role model, a person like, oh, you know, I'd like to be in his position around?
Hell yes.
Like who, for example?
Like Tom Waits.
Mm-hmm.
Like Lou Reed.
Mm-hmm.
Like Allen Ginsberg.
Mm-hmm.
De Niro. De Niro.
Oh, De Niro,
Yeah, just, and people who, and Dylan, you know, people who have had an actual life have come through flame after flame, either on their own, or, you know, their own flame, or the flames of people hating them, or completely elevating them to God status, and them still being around. And then, actually, I mean, the last two things that Dylan did were great. You know, he is beautiful still, and mm-hmm. and I appreciate that, and I'm happy.
And
or like William S. Burroughs.
Mm-hmm.
You know, still, he hasn't lost any of his shock.
Those are all people who, throughout their long careers, have paid attention to their craft only, it seems. They're not really swayed by the what's in vogue or the times in any way.
Well, I'm part of the times,
uh-huh.
so I can't really help but be, you know, reflect my life
mm-hmm.
in this time and age. And you know, I just do it the way I do it,
mm-hmm.
and it'll change and grow.
The guy here notes that the industry as a whole seems to really have taken to you, or the music business, that is. You know, the press, the electronic media.
Electronic media, really?
Well, I mean, you know, television.
Oh, I see. I thought you meant, like, you know, computer people.
Well, computer people, too.
Really?
Well, I see your name a lot on the...
Internet.
Keyboards. Yeah.
You're kidding.
Yeah, I mean, it's not everywhere. It's not like, you know, the latest fad or anything. But yeah, people have been talking about you.
All I can say to that is, let's wait like 2-3 years down the line.
Mm-hmm. So you want to prove yourself, and you want to.
I just I'm honored and I'm happy,
mm-hmm.
you know. But it's not what makes my world go round,
mm-hmm.
and it's not what's going to keep the thing going. It's just simply to be appreciated and acknowledged, and I'm happy, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's queer. It's actually very, very strange.
Mm-hmm.
It's just very strange. I don't know how to react to it. Just to say, thank you, sir. Thank you, madam.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't think I've seen a negative...
Would you like some fries with that?
Pardon me? Would
you like some fries with that? What were you about to say?
I don't think I've seen a negative word written about you, though.
Oh, I have.
Really?
That's plenty. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. Yeah. Of course.
But it seems like... But mostly, it's positive, though.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I guess you're hitting the right buttons.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. I'm glad they like it. I'm just glad people like music in general.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing is that I may come out with something that I think is the most eloquent thing I can say, and people just won't get it. It's totally a crapshoot. Or Grace will hang around, and people will see that it's, you know, worthless. Or people, I don't know, like, music is very strange. Sometimes it hangs around for years, and you hate it. And you think it is the most stinky corpse you can possibly have in your house, and I don't want to see it anymore. But one day it creeps in, and you get a moment where you actually need that song. Maybe it's because of her. Maybe it's because of him. Maybe it's because of what you need, or I don't know, or somebody dying. But that's the way music is. It's not, it doesn't, you know, it's not like Sega, you know. Like, you get it in, it either works and excites you, or it doesn't. It's not like that. It's sort of, well, in some places, but some songs just sort of, and music just sort of hangs around and gets in you like a wasp. So I'm just saying that music needs time to live in, and while I'm happy about the accolades and about any acceptance or any, you know, liking of the music, it needs an ongoing dialogue.
Are you still receptive to other people's music? A lot of times musicians, you know...
Oh, totally.
Really? I mean, your own career hasn't changed you at all as a fan?
No, not at all.
Really?
I'll always be a slobbering idiot for people who love.
So like, what kind of things are you listening to now?
Oh, the Grifters, Patti Smith, the new Ginsberg box set, MC5. Totally pulled out that one. You ever heard of Juan Esquivel?
No.
He's sort of like if Speedy Gonzalez, as a game show host, had sex with Duke Ellington on acid. That's what it sounds like.
Oh, I see.
Totally, like, in love with this music. I listen to Sun Ra, I listen to, you know, Kiss, anything. Led Zeppelin, Bad Brains, Shudder to Think. Some, you know, music my friends make. Our jam tapes, I totally adore.
There's a question here about Pearl Jam.
Jeff Almond came to see our show in Seattle, and it was very nice. What about him? What about them?
About them, it's like this guy sees you as sort of sharing the same kind of attitude. I think this maybe what he's referring to is an attention to integrity, artistic integrity.
Well, good. But I mean, you could say that about Soundgarden as well. Everybody does. Nobody wants to fucking sell themselves. Although maybe it's I know that I'm a whore. I know that I will do anything possible to do this. So I'm a fucking whore. Yeah, whatever. But
But it seems like you're.
It's just that I enjoy my sex. You know.
Oh, I see. Okay. But I mean, it seems like you're a little bit more choosy, a little more.
It's just the conceptual artist in me sees places where I feel like I don't belong and places where I do. There's no need to bang my head against the wall so early, you know, and try to win people over at Six Flags Magic Mountain or, you know, why not go to a place where people who really want to hear it come? You know, I've never traveled in packs. I've always sort of been on the outside. I've always been the stranger. It's just more, and art works better in places where you are allowed to have your deepest eccentricities come out, and you need a really good space for that. And sometimes it's bars, and sometimes it's like Trinity Church in Toronto.
But by the same token,
sometimes it's, we played in a burrito restaurant the other night. It was amazing, a little church. Anyway, sorry.
But I guess by the same token, though, if you got, you know, turned into a big rock star and we're playing like stadiums or something, would the music then lose something?
No, because one, I'll never be playing the stadiums. Two, the conceptual artist in me would see a stadium and would go, what sort of material would be completely filled with subtlety and nuance in a big fucking stadium? And also rock and hold an entire stadium. That would be quite a challenge indeed. But I don't like stadium shows because usually the act on the stage is so big that people take them for granted, and you know, like in the middle of a song they don't understand it, they go away and buy a program or a hot dog or a beer or something, and it's not a musical experience. It's just like a swap meet, it's like an event. That would kill me. I'd be so sad.
So you're pretty demanding of your audience. You want them to really...
No, I'm not. I'm not really. I really am not demanding of the audience, because they can do whatever they want, but it's just...
You don't think that kind of atmosphere would be conducive to
yeah.
artistic performance?
No. Unless you're like Paul McCartney and you know, whip out... Live and Let Die in a stadium with like fireworks and big screens and an amazing light show and a band that knows the songs and it sounds exactly like a huge, larger than life version of it. And I listen to I saw that. Or like if you write Hey Jude, now that you've heard that song so long that it totally translates. You've heard it so well, but this music you don't know well, you know, at first. And it needs attention. You know? But, you know, you don't have to, I don't demand that you sit there and be quiet. You can, you know, maybe you came to the gig to talk to your friend that you haven't seen for 16 years or try to, you know, chat up a girl. Mm-hmm. I'm not about to stop that.
Mm-hmm.